Hello students, welcome on our e-learning platform. As we are going through with our subject CLSP, and in that subject yesterday we have started the new section of our syllabus, that is the process of incorporation. How many stages are involved in incorporation or formation of the company? And this is my sincere request that this is a very important point or a topic of our syllabus, and you should be very serious while studying this specific topic. So yesterday we have started with the 11 steps. There are total near about 11 steps in the formation of the company, because if you go through with the different books you will find there are different steps, but as per the Company Act 2013, the latest innovations which is made regarding the corporation and formation of the company contains these much steps. So continuing with our last lecture which I have delivered you yesterday, I have covered 6 steps in that out of total 11 steps or 11 processes. So starting with the obtaining the DSC, that is Digital Signature Certificate. The very first stage was obtaining a digital signature certificate. Why it is required? Because nowadays all the statements, all the work related to the financial statements or a balance sheet even of a company, it is e-filed. The documents are filed with the department, with the government departments by emails, or everything is done online, and for that reason that digital signature is necessary or compulsory. So digital signature certificate of the directors, so first the promoters have to obtain that particular certificate for the purpose of e-filing. Okay, that we have seen. The next was register DSC. So obtaining DSC, the stage do not end there. The next further stage is register DSC in the name of director with MCA, Ministry of Corporate Affairs. What is that? Ministry of Corporate Affairs. So that particular DSC must registered in the name of director with MCA. Then we have gone through with obtain the DIN number, director identification number. It means the persons who will be acting as a director, they must have that specific number which is necessary for a director. The person who is going to operate or who is going to be a director of the company, he must have that DIN number, director's identification number. It is very obvious that his identity is declared or his identity is identified with that specific number which is known as DIN number. We have seen that obtaining DIN. Then apply for reservation of the name. Again, this is one of the important thing, because your name, whichever the name you want to say or you want to declare for your company, that should not be repeated. So for that reason you should reserve the name in advance with ROC, Register of Company. You have to complete as necessary and a simple process for reserving the name with the ROC, and once you apply for that particular thing, apply a reservation of name, applying for the reservation of the name for the proposed company. Then we have seen finalizing MOA and AOA. What is that? Now I hope you are very much familiar with this terms, Memorandum of Association and Articles of Association. What they have to do? They have to finalize, they have to prepare the draft of MOA and AOA. Okay, because these are the very essential and important documents which has to be prepared by the promoters in case of new company or forming a new company or incorporating a new company. Then the next is signing, stamping and dating of MOA and AOA. What is that? Only preparation. The next to the stage of the preparation of MOA and AOA is signing. Okay, every director with the proof, with the presence of at least one other director, they must sign that MOA, because they are the subscribers. They have to subscribe their name, they have to add their name in Memorandum of Association. So signing, then they have to stamp it. Okay, under the Indian Stamping Companies Act 1899, that particular document. Which is that document? Memorandum and article that must be stamped, and afterwards the date must be there on that particular MOA. And for that reason, for the stamping reason, some stamp duty has been also be paid for the reason of stamping of MOA and AOA. Now today we will start with deciding the address of the company. Now first, that is preparing the necessary documents for the incorporation. Now while preparing the documents for incorporation, what has to be taken care in preparing necessary documents? The consent of directors, the persons who want to be the first directors, the promoters itself, themselves are the first directors, but the consent must be received from each and every promoter who is going to be the first director, so that they are ready to act to work as a directors. Then a list of the persons who have agreed to be the first directors along with their written consent should be prepared. The consent should not be verbal, but that consent must be a written consent. Their personal details like DIN number, proof of identity and interest in the form of companies etc. should be included in that particular list. Okay, once the consent has been received, then the details of managers and secretary. The who is going to be the secretary of the company, the designation of the secretary, the person who is going to be appointed as a secretary, his details must be there in that particular document. Okay, then declaration by the subscribers to MOA. Okay, a declaration should be taken from each subscriber to the MOA, and every person named as a first director in the articles of association that he is convicted for any offense in this connection. What it means? They should not have any court case in their name. If something is there, some liability which is judicial, or they are involved in such activity that some court case is filed in their name by someone else, it means they might have made some fraud or a crime, it means why there is a court case in their name, that should be identified. Means they should be clear from every illegal activity which is not eligible. Means the persons who are going to work as a director, okay, so for that reason, before subscribing their name, all these things should be verified. Okay, that is what is declaration or declare. Then deciding address for communication. Address for communication is one of the important thing. Once you have started your activity and it is found that you do not have your permanent address, that is called also called a postal address. It means what? You do not have any space to run the office. So it is judged, means it is observed that the business which you want to open, the business which is proposed, is not having a address. So it means it is treated as something wrong is in that proposed business. So that is the advanced stage, that is the process which has to be completed by the promoters, that is deciding the address for communication. With what will be the address for the communication? And that is why only the preliminary contracts which we have discussed for hiring a house, for hiring a rental house, the promoters can make a agreement that is known as preliminary agreements with the landlords, with the landowners for hiring the house. Now why it is required? Here for desiring the address for communication. Okay, the next is obtaining statutory declaration forms. Whatever the documents, whatever the forms, whatever the information which has been submitted by the first directors, promoters, the proposed advocates and the chartered accountants, cost accountant, company secretaries, it must be a statutory declaration form. So for that reason, the form is there and it should be mentioned. So it is statutory form, it is compulsory. From the opening of a new company, the process, the steps which are included in the incorporation of the company. What it says, at the time of incorporation, if the proposed company has not decided its location of registered office, they must do that. They must provide the address. At the same time, an advocate practicing as a company secretary or a cost accountant or a CA who is engaged in the formation of the company and persons named in the articles of association as a director, manager or secretary stating that all requirements related to incorporation has been compiled. It means what? Whatever the information, the declaration given by them is compulsory and it is compiled with. It means they have provided all the details which are true and believable, so they can go forward with the process of incorporation of the company. Then filing of application and documents for incorporation with ROC. After all the documents are prepared, the promoters have to submit the application to the registrar of the company. So ROC means what? Registrar of company. Registrar So, after all the documents are prepared, the promoters have to submit an application to the registrar of company in the prescribed form along with all necessary documents and the prescribed fees for the incorporation. So, for the purpose of incorporation, certain fees has to be also paid before receiving the certificate of incorporation. So, now filing this. Now, in this case of filing, they have to file, okay, and this all is mentioned where that is known as simplified. Yesterday I have also told you that SPICE. So SPICE stands for simplified pro forma for incorporating company, and that E stands for electronically, okay. Again, I will write here SPICE. This is a form. This form must be filed. Okay, this form must be filled and submitted to the ROC. Now, this form contains, okay, simplified pro forma for incorporating company. Simplified pro forma for incorporating company electronically. That is SPICE 32. इसका नाम होता है, दिस इज द नेम ऑफ द फॉर्म. सो हियर इन दिस फॉर्म, व्हाट आर द कंटेंट्स ऑफ दिस फॉर्म्स, व्हाट एवर द इंफॉर्मेशन व्हिच हैज बीन फिल्ड इन दिस फॉर्म, द डिटेल्स आर रिजर्वेशन ऑफ द नेम ऑफ द कंपनी, देन इनकॉर्पोरेशन ऑफ अ न्यू कंपनी, देन डीन ऑफ द डायरेक्टर्स, डीन नंबर ऑफ द डायरेक्टर्स, पैन नंबर, ओके, परमानेंट अकाउंट नंबर, that stands for PAN number and TAN number, tax deduction number. So all the details which must be filled, which must be in the form SPICE, all the details must be filled by the promoters in the specific form, so that the last process, the last stage of the incorporation can be completed. So for the reason of obtaining a certificate of incorporation, now once all the formalities are completed up to the 10 stages, okay, the stages which we have discussed yesterday and even today, okay, we have started with preparing necessary documents for incorporation, then deciding address for the communication, obtaining statutory declaration form, filing an application and documents for incorporation with ROC, where this particular form SPICE, and in that form what contents are there, what details must be fulfilled by the promoters, that is reservation of the name, then incorporation of a new company, DIN number, PAN number, TAN number. All the details which are in that particular form must be filled by the promoters. And the lastly, obtaining a certificate of incorporation. Here the process of incorporation ends. Okay. And lastly, the obtaining the certificate of incorporation from ROC. Now it is up to the promoters to go to the ROC, to go that particular office and ask the ROC for this certificate of incorporation. Once they receive the certificate of incorporation, then what are the points or how the certificate of incorporation looks like, okay, in that certain
points are mentioned, or when that certificate you receive, maybe by e-certificate or a physical certificate, in that case you must go through that whether that certificate contains these details or not. So what are the contents of that particular CIN? The name of the company, okay, the proposed name which was given by the promoters has been finalized by ROC. So first is the name of the company, the name in which you want to open or start a new business, that is the name of the company. Secondly, date of issue of certificate. There is a date of issue of the certificate. On which date that particular certificate has been issued. Then thirdly, SIN number, that is certificate of incorporation. Then PAN number, just now I have told you, permanent account number. TAN number, tax deduction number. Then lastly, the signature of the ROC with date and his seal. So you will find that the certificate of incorporation looks like this. This is the certificate of incorporation. Every company who is going to start their new business, to open their new business, they receive this certificate, and unless they receive this certificate, they cannot start their business activity. So this is for your reference, and today we have completed the all the stages involved in the incorporation or formation of new company. Thank you.